Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to SANTANA. And the song that we are going to react to is the song of the wind. This is our first time single take honest reaction.
Let's get started with it and then we'll give our spontaneous impromptu review. Even our reaction is spontaneous, impromptu and always unscripted.
Yes.
Let's get started, song of the wind.
Thank you.
Wow, this was an experience.
You know, today in the same recording session, we reacted to Cream and the song Crossroads. And Eric Clapton on the guitars there, killer, killer, killer guitar playing. Now we are reacting to Santana and the song of the wind. It was very nice. It was very, very nice guitar playing by Santana. It was Carlos Santana. But I have a small problem here, and that is the other music was good, but it was way too loud at the parallel level of the guitar. I like the drums, and I think there were a couple of drums that were being played.
Yeah, one was mainly the cymbals, playing the cymbals, and one was the native drums of Mexico.
And then the bass guitar was actually good. It was good bridge between the rest. But I found the other music, there was another guitar as well. The other music was way too loud for his guitar to, you know, shine at all times. Only towards the end I could really feel his guitar, otherwise it was an imbalance, kind of an imbalance.
Yeah, that's true, that's true. It's a very valid observation. Because I'm a fan of Santana, I would have probably not said that.
Mm-hmm.
But I completely agree with you that when you have such a classy guitarist, and that could be seen with Cream.
Yeah.
You know, they had Eric Clapton. And Eric Clapton it was.
And Eric Clapton.
Center stage was Eric Clapton. Yes. Here you have Santana.
Carlos
Santana. The group is named after him.
Yeah.
He should have been given the center stage. He should have been the loudest. And it should have been all him. But that's the beauty of a band as well. You know, I mean, if you look at the positive.
Right.
The reason for it is that it's a band. And yeah, they all need their space to. They on their own, they may be really talented too. You know, the person who plays on native drums,
he's
pretty talented
as well.
I'm
hoping they can get solos or something like that.
I completely agree with you. Yeah. I get that. I definitely feel he should have been louder. And he should have been given his freedom to play.
A little bit.
And also, like, they have a cappella. Mm-hmm. And we've heard some miserable a cappella recently with pentatonics. But I wish that it was only the guitar solo. You know, for a while they should have only been the guitar.
Yeah.
No other instrument.
Nothing
the
else.
Proper solo, by definition, is only when you have the sound of that principal instrument. So there should have been a solo, and that would have definitely balanced things out beautifully. In fact, it would have made us love the song a lot more. But because that wasn't there, definitely I agree with Kirti. And yeah, but because I'm a fan at the same time, I overlooked it because I'm such a big fan of these guys, whether it's Eric Clapton, whether it's Carlos Santana, whether it's Slash, whether it's so many others, you know.
Jimi Hendrix,
yeah, but unfortunately we've never listened to him.
I think we can't react, right?
Who knows, maybe now we can. I mean,
okay.
some patron gives it a... does a test video and sends it to us, we know we can do it.
Nice.
But either ways, they should pick the right song, for heaven's sake.
Okay.
Yeah, there are songs which are very controversial, and unfortunately we may not be able to focus on only the music then.
Mm-hmm.
So it has to be about the patron also. There's no such thing as a bad song, only a bad patron. But anyway, that's it for this one. Enjoyable nevertheless, but should have given Carlos Santana center stage. I suppose he's the one who made those decisions anyway.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's
whatever.
He should have made
sometimes lapse in judgment also, or taste. Thank you for watching.